reading the pages of my mind.
Martian motion out to the right. Here's a pitch to Mitchell. Mitchell starts to take off to the right. Now cuts back to the left at the 8-yard line. He's slanting toward the end zone.
Pump fake now. Looks, throws to the end zone.
There it is.
Touchdown, Seahawks!
Shotgun back on third and three. Throws in the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks, the Blades! His second touchdown reception this afternoon.
You are looking at the flag flying over the kingdom tonight, flying at half-mast by order of King County Executive Tim Hill, in honor of the voice of the Seahawks, Cairo's own Pete Gross. Hello again, everybody, and welcome to this very special edition of 7:30. For the next half hour, we're going to remember our very good friend and colleague, Pete Gross. As most of you by now know, Pete died last night after a long and valiant battle against cancer. He leaves a wonderful family behind, his wife, Bev, his daughters, Susie and Debbie and Wendy. Pete also leaves behind many friends, several of whom are joining us here tonight at the Kingdom in the very booth where, as I mentioned a few moments ago, Pete broadcast football games for these Seahawks for 17 seasons. We're going to begin by looking back at the career of the man known as the voice of the Seahawks. This is a tribute to a man who was truly loved by all of his co-workers at Cairo and respected by everybody in this area who ever heard his work.
Back to pass. He eludes the rush by long. He throws to the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks!
Words were Pete Gross's paintbrush. His split-second descriptions, pure artistry.
Give the ball to Smith, who circles up inside across the 20, fumbles the ball.
Fueling the listener's imagination.
Washington with a second interception, gets up, runs toward the middle of the field, circling out now to the 10, up the left side, 15-yard line, getting over a man and gets hammered down from behind at the 21-yard line.
And he did it all with a wonderful sense of humor. Boo, boo. Never giving in to the chemotherapy steadily being fed into his body from a pack on his belt.
I enjoy talking about it because it's kind of therapy for me. And I said, well, you know, maybe if people can see that I've still got hope and that things are going to happen, maybe it'll stimulate them a little bit.
In 1988, Pete Gross was diagnosed with cancer. There were several operations, years of treatment, but ultimately there was nothing the doctors could do.
A lot of people, you know, whine, why me? Why did I get this and all that stuff? I mean, who knows? It's a mystery. And I've always said, tomorrow, I could cross the street at Cairo and get hit by a car and go that way. So, you know, you never know when your time is here.
One, two, three. More music on KXOA.
One, two, three.
Wilson Pickett, Land of a Thousand Dances. Go ahead, step on his foot.
For a time in the 1960s, for the folks in Watsonville, California, Pete Gross was known as the Prince of Rock and Roll. He cut his broadcasting teeth there as a boss jock using the radio name Tony King.
Summer fun time on the Tony King function at the Junction.
His love of old-time rock and roll never waned. He was a collector of hard-to-find 45s.
Dave Clark 5 had some good stuff. Stones. There are only a few things that I really, really genuinely like by the Stones. And same for the Love and Spoonful.
Look, it's a mess.
In 1973, Cairo News Radio in Seattle hired him to call the University of Washington football and basketball games. 3 years later, Gross got the call he always really wanted, with a brand new team in the NFL, the Seattle Seahawks.
Zorn on a quick count, drops back to pass, dampers out to his right, throws upfield, complete to Smith at the 10 to 5. He is in, touchdown Seahawks!
And that's when we first heard his signature phrase. Pete talked about those famous words for us a year ago.
I'm going back to the 76 49er game, the first game ever played here, and I took out the tape and heard that, and all of a sudden you just started saying that, and you know, it kind of catches on, and it's kind of the way you say it. I mean, you can say it certain ways, and it kind of catches people's ears, and then all of a sudden they expect you to say it every touchdown, so then you're kind of stuck with it. You don't have any choice.
But there was one touchdown Seahawks in Cincinnati on December 10th, 1989, that marked a deeply personal and memorable moment in Gross's life.
Craig back a pass, little pump fake, now looks, throws to the end zone.
There it is!
Touchdown!
100.
Steve Largent's 100th career touchdown catch. After the game, Largent gave his jersey, one that was destined for the Hall of Fame, to Pete Gross.
I remember hugging him, and then I just remember standing there after everybody had left for about a minute, looking at this jersey, and it was so just overwhelming to me. I mean, I just couldn't move. I just stood there and looked at this jersey. For a person who's in this business and supposed to be able to express themselves verbally or write something, I was totally speechless.
Largent, along with former Hawk players Jim Zorn and Dave Brown, recently joined Gross in what proved to be his final appearance at the Kingdome. The Seahawks bestowed their highest honor on Gross, inducting him into the team's Ring of Honor, the only non-player to be so recognized.
Thank you all very much for being a part of this. And if the Seahawks maybe can get two or three touchdown Seahawks, I will go beat Denver.
Snap, spot, kick.
And after winning the game, a final tribute to the only play-by-play man the team and the fans have ever known.
You have the gold ball to Pete Gross.
To his co-workers, Gross was a consummate pro, one of the best prepared announcers in the NFL. By his family, he'll be remembered as a loving husband and father to his wife Bev and three daughters, Debbie, Wendy, and Susie. And for fans across the Pacific Northwest, Pete Gross will always be the man who took them into the middle of the action, who made their sports a little more exciting, who made all of us the richer for having known him. Pete Gross, the voice of the Seahawks.